Ladies and gentlemen, we are live from Nationwide Arena. It is Championship Sunday. After 6 days, we are down to our final two teams, and only one of them will wear the crown. But before we get to the finals, we're gonna have some fun. We're kicking things off with the All-Star Game, and I know you guys are gonna make some noise this morning, right? It's gonna be Na'Vi versus Luminosity in the grand final. But here today, you voted them in. It's time for the All-Stars. Let's kick it off with Team Europe. And our first player is Michael Laley, MC Michael Laley, the beatbox champion. Let's bring him out. Also representing the European All-Stars, we have another member of the FaZe Clan, the God of Thunder. Give it up for Rain! He didn't make it to the arena, but he played incredible all week long. It's the only mouse you'll ever be afraid of. Give it up for Nico! Representing the boys in blue. If you've ever been on YouTube, you've seen this man's clips. Give it up for the legendary opera, Kenny S. And here to put the Americans to bed early, it's the Ninja in Pajamas. Get right. A stacked lineup right there for Europe. But on the other side of the stage, it's time for Team America. This guy got it. Bringing out our first player. It's the Silent Sniper. Give it up for Liquid. Sorry, it's not Hiko yet. It's time for Skadoodle. Master of the front page of Reddit. You already know, it's time for Shroud. And keep it rolling for the beast from the Middle East, representing CLG, it's Tarek. Ukraine, I'm sorry, but he's ours now. Representing America here today, give it up for Simple. And last but not least, it's the Clutch King, except after round 15. Give it up for Hiko. Sorry, Hiko, too soon. Guys, we are in store for one hell of a matchup and bringing you the commentary for this first match of the day. It's three of my favorite Brits. Let's send it over to the desk with Red Eye, Richard Lewis, and Thorin.
Wow. I don't know if Chris Bucket's actually a European, but what a start.
He really hates North America, by the way.
Seems to, right? Seems to break them straight away.
Thought he was from here.
How are you doing anyway? Good morning.
Yeah, very good morning. Yeah. I don't know what this is about. I don't know why they put us on here. Whatever.
What I heard was, MLG basically said that for an all-star game, they needed an all-star cast for the commentary team. Unfortunately, there was just me, Richard, and Thorin.
Yep, that was it. The rest of the cast is still in bed, hungover, of course. Anders, crippling alcoholic. Everyone knows. Worst kept secret in the industry, of course.
We're going to try and keep this semi-serious at some point. We might get serious. So where's this going? Sorry. This is easy, right? This is Europe all the way.
Well, I mean, it helps that there's six European players playing, so I feel like Europe wins in some sense no matter what, yeah.
I mean, it's got to be said as well, like, I think 4chan must have got hold of the voting or something for this, because I'm looking at that European team, I'm like, two phase players, is this real life?
I think the first question is, where are the Astralis players, where are the Fnatic players? Yeah, is it just because the voters said, they'll probably get to the final, so I won't vote for those?
I mean, of course, like, this is actually...
Speaking of someone who's two-phased.
Nice, edgy. It's a good
one of Puckett's alternate lines there for Hiko when he's coming out.
And obviously this is a good opportunity for Nico over in Europe as well, because for once he gets to play with competent players. So.
I'm expecting a big game from the Sky Shroud, meaningless game just for the fans. only spectators to watch. No judgment.
But yeah, on a serious note, like I actually think NA have probably got the slightly better deal here.
Yeah, I think they've got I'm looking
definitely relative to the regions. They've got pretty much the best players you could want.
I mean, that is actually what a North American All-Star team would look like, maybe give or take one names. Meanwhile, over in Europe, yeah, perhaps a few surprise inclusions. I think people, picking the popular players, maybe not assembling the strongest lineup ever. But I mean, it is a bit of fun. So I'm not gonna take it.
Absolutely. But there is some pride on the line here. And I know there's a few people in the crowd who would like to see America win today.
Yeah.
Just a few.
Panda harder.
Wait, that's what I'm here for.
Scoots. Blown out, of course.
but the point to make about the European team is obviously Na'Vi can't play because they're in the final, but Astralis and Fnatic do have a few star players in them that might have been useful on this team. Then again, though, that also just shows the wealth of talent that Europe has, because players like, I mean, Nico isn't in a top elite level team, and yet he is a fantastic player, so. Yeah. And Kenny S, his team went out last place, but he is still one of the best players in the world. So the talent pool is deep enough that it's obviously still going to be a great game. Mm.
Yeah. Is there anyone in there you would have wanted to see, Rich? That's not there?
I mean, obviously, there's a few names. Some of them are in the final, of course.
Yeah,
we should explain
that, actually. Anyone playing in the final can't play in the All-Star game. So
I mean, obviously, I'd love to see Guardian go off. I don't think he's had a particularly great tournament here.
I think by his own admission, he said yesterday, he hasn't really played that well.
I think the All-Star game might be a welcome distraction for him. And look, Device as well, you know, like... get him in there, but you know, you've got Get Right and Kenny S, and Get Right's not just an all-star player currently in terms of what he brings to his team at NIP. I mean, he's just an all-star throughout his entire career. You know? So lots of pressure on him. I'm looking forward to see Kenny S. Obviously, it would have been it's a travesty envious aren't here. But,
absolutely, get a chance for the crowd to see what he can do.
Exactly, on
the big stage.
I think you know, envious obviously have their problems. On a serious note, it is kind of sad to not see Kenny S, who had that great story out in Cluj. You know, so hopefully he can put on a show for us here today.
Yeah,
so
absolutely. Sorry, I'm really interested in how the strategy is going to work in this game.
Can I answer Rich's question as well? Can I say who I want to see?
No, of course.
Because it's an obvious name, right? Because look, over on the North American side, they've kind of cheated. They've got this simple guy, and he's a very good player, but he's from the Ukraine. So an obvious AWPer we could have put in there is a Dren. I mean, he was the MVP of a series last night, guys.
I'm feeling some wrecking coming up.
He dominated for Luminosity. He got him to the final. Listen, North American players never even got to fight. He got another team to the final.
If you're a friend of Adren, can you call him and just make sure he's all right, please? Because Thorin's wrecking him here. This is unacceptable.
Anyway. Thing is, though, I'm actually hoping in this game, I joked about Shroud, but let's be real. I mean, Kenny S, Shroud, these guys haven't been on this stage, okay? They don't know what the big light's about. I hope they don't buckle under the pressure, you know? They went out 0-2. This is a big game for them, guys. They're playing against some top, top players here.
So anyway, it looks like we're getting into the veto, so time for some
Nico theatrics. Just overjoyed to actually have competent teammates.
Wait a minute.
Do I have to get 50 in this game? Or just play like normally, mate. Yeah, okay, 40. No, just play your normal role. But I do get paid more than that. Well, okay, maybe not for that one, mate. Maybe not that one.
Veto's underway.
Yeah, I've got the bands coming
in. I've got a really weird feeling about this, Rich. How about you?
Yeah, it's tulip all the way.
Yeah, I don't know. You know, cobblestones out, trains out.
I mean, we know because Hiko's in the team, it's obviously not going to be Overpass or Mirage. They're not feeling that map right now.
PTSD. Yeah. Okay. To the map.
So we've got Cash or Nuke. Cash or Nuke? No. What's the other one? Hang on, what am I missing? Aztec. It's going to be Aztec.
Office.
Definitely Office.
Where's it going to go?
Could be Mirage.
What do you know?
Well, North America known for it ruling the world through nuclear superiority. And we're going to go back to the facility, boys, where they're all made. Let's see what makes America great. Let's go see some nukes.
All joking aside, this is a good map for America.
Because it hasn't been played competitively for over a year. Only people who play matchmaking play. Yeah, Shroud's probably going to dominate, mate. He knows what he's doing. The other players, they're all playing pro matches, tournaments. He's on his stream. He's had a bit of vertigo. And this guy has had a bit of PTSD from the team he's been in for a while.
Yeah. Poor get right.
I mean, he's just looking forward to playing a game that have five actual pro players in it. He's like, I forgot what that's like.
Being serious for a second, I'm actually looking forward
to seeing... Why are you going to do that? Now, why are you going to do something?
Just for a second. Just for a second.
Richard, if you must.
I know, I'm looking forward to seeing you, because obviously when it came out and it was like reintroduced, people were like, we don't know how to play this. There isn't really a meta around it. It feels too T-sided now. So having top-level players play it might kind of help flesh it out a little bit. So I'm looking forward to see how it actually pans out, whether it's still got some of the issues when it was reintroduced or whether these players can kind of crack the nut. So.
And of course, Makaleli, his career so decorated that actually it's not even on the team that he's representing in an All-Star game at the Major. Already left beforehand.
Yeah, that tweet was crazy, right?
Yeah. Well, he's sat next to his teammate.
Yeah, I know.
Well, his ex-teammate.
Yeah.
Speaking of crazy tweets,
awesome.
So Old Simple there, that famous North American player.
Oh, yeah, it's brilliant.
He made a tweet yesterday after the games. You know, people are probably wondering, what's he going to say? Is he going to say, like, you know, I'll be back to win the next match? He actually made a tweet. It just said, I'm leaving Team Liquid. And everyone was like, wait, what? No, we almost made it to the final. And then afterwards, he tweeted, like, basically Moses came up to him and said, like, yeah, like, what are you doing, man? Like, why would you say, are you really leaving? And he goes, no, it's April Fool's. Moses goes, well, that was like 2 days ago. And he goes, yes, but I didn't do anything on that day, so I got it now.
Only Simple could think, like, I'm just going to move April Fool's. It's actually better if you do that. Having it on a fixed day is problematic.
People say he's kind of stubborn, wants things his way. Actually, April Fool's on the third now, yeah. So.
That's how we go.
I want it my way.
Yeah.
Basically, Burger King. He's already in America. He's already adapted to their ways, where you don't just get the burger that you asked for. Get any burger you want. In fact, just have a burger. That's mainly the slogan, right? Have a burger any way you want, and there's your autumn.
You're not getting out of this stadium, mate.
At least not with these legs intact, anyway.
No.
We're not far away from starting. I want to talk about Nuke. Nuke, what's your view on this? Because it has been changed. It has been updated. It has been modified yet again.
I remember, obviously, been in Counter-Strike a while, same with Duncan. I remember some legendary games on Nuke.
Yeah, me too.
Back in the day, both in 1.6 and in Source. And it's always been one of those maps where it kind of like, it just did feel too CT-sided. But then again, it did lend itself to these incredible comebacks. And I've seen comebacks like from 14-1 down on this map.
15-0, and then over the years.
So it did have that, what you would call an imbalance. But all the original Counter-Strike maps were inherently imbalanced. Mm. You know, they were predominantly CT-sided. Yeah. So that was kind of one of the things, you know. But yeah, this is way more balanced now, apparently. So I am looking forward to seeing how it looks like
America's team are going to start CT side, which in theory, if it plays anyway like it used to, then that's great. But,
yeah, but
I'm not so sure because I actually played this a little bit recently and it's pretty good for T's now.
Yeah, there's so much space sort of like come through and you can just dominate sort of
you can just jump along and come along the top railing
area, the catwalk, come all the way around.
So it makes it a lot harder to cover the outside, the warehouse area.
Yeah.
There's no real skill jump to get on the top of what used to be yellow anymore.
Yeah, and the CT rotations are a lot harder now as well. So you've got way more ground to cover. You know, you just used to be able to just stick a couple of people in the vents and bounce them down.
Yeah, and then we add in the kind of lack of team chemistry.
Yeah.
Because it might not be a huge amount here, let's be fair.
It's gonna be a glorious mess. Yeah. Like this cast. It's appropriate, of course.
It is, yeah. Who do you think is gonna call in? He's probably gonna call the Americans, right?
I mean, again, one thing I do know about the North American players are, I think they're also, ego-based, that I don't think anyone's going to be allowed to call. I think they'll all be calling over each other.
I mean, the funny thing is, a bunch of these North American players not only have been on teams together, but will have played tons of 10-mans.
Yeah,
FPL.
Exactly.
So actually, in some sense, they probably have an advantage over the Europeans in that way.
Okay, here we go then, ladies and gentlemen. Hold on to your seats. It's America versus Europe for the MLG All-Star Game here at the Major. The grand final, of course, is this afternoon as well. I can't wait to see how it all pans out, especially who gets the bragging rights. Is it the All-Star Americans or the All-Star Europeans? As Thorin already said, there are six Europeans in here. Tactical timeout, round one.
And apparently, Tarek wants to be considered Turkish anyway, so we're running out of Americans here, boys.
I know. There you go. Someone just shouted Trout's Canadian as well. Yeah. This is a disgrace. It's a sham. I'm done. I'm out. Going home. Right, here we are.
I'm going to bring those jobs back from Europe, guys.
That's it. Like, America's even outsourcing its Counter-Strike players these days. Like, what's going on?
Yeah, we Kenny do have a timeout at the start of the game, so it's obviously, you know,
trolling.
Called by Europeans, bit of trolling early on, just to send a message. It's not quite a good Carrigan BM timeout, not really.
Take a leaf out of Carrigan's, but absolutely wrecked Fnatic. That was brilliant. One of my all-time favourite esports moments, that, I think. No, it's straight up there. Yeah, amazing. Yeah. That and Scoot's getting booed.
Which, that was pretty good.
Yeah, it was amazing. Just to clarify that as well, because obviously, like, apparently there was some people...
There was something else going on.
Yeah, something else going on in the background. So it wasn't Scoot.
It was just
the timing. Scoot didn't know that, though.
Yeah, he was... I love you guys.
You've turned on me after all this time. I was one of you. Many, many years ago, of course.
Many, many years.
Now I'm but a shadow of my former self.
Follow the yellow brick road. Scoots the Munchkin King.
I think we should have some sort of meter on the screen for how much wrecking is going on with you two.
Well, that's what we're here for.
Yeah. I think it'd be off the screen, unfortunately. That's the problem. Right, here we go then. 5 seconds and we can get underway. Finally, after a tactical timeout by the Europeans. In the before the opening round even begins, so finally we can get underway in the All-Star game.
Tough crowd. Is this thing on?
Whoa!
Of course, it's been a long time since the European players only had $150 in their bank accounts.
Yeah, I was gonna.
They don't remember those days. 2013.
Here we go then. Europe on the T side. With Kenny S, Michael Eddy, Nico, Get Right, and Rain. You won't see these players playing together for a long time, that's for sure. So enjoy this.
Especially not Rain and McAlealy.
And already we've got Kenny S moving in. Skadoodle has taken a position up outside, actually. Right now picks up the first kill of the day. Headshot from Skadoodle. Michael Eddy will come back with a trade, though. And the push is towards the outside right now. Ooh. Simple with a double. Easy. Can he get a third here? And the answer is yes, he can. Another headshot. Nico, though, replied back with a double of himself on the inside. And it's now down to a 1v2 after being a 1v4. Can Nico come up clutch now?
I've been here before,
exactly,
guys.
Yeah.
All my teammates have died.
Yeah. Dennis, Spiddy, what are you doing? Oh, wait, no, I'm in the All-Star game.
then again, you look at who was voted in this time. I'm surprised they're not here with him, mate. And welcoming the European All-Star, Dennis.
Oh, right. Great round from Simple.
Great round.
Four,
a four kill from Simple.
He's playing amazing considering
one.
He's got a crippling hangover. It's not bad.
Yeah. Yeah, I saw that glass of water you handed him last night.
He's Ukrainian. He can take it.
Keep emphasizing that, Rich.
Yeah.
Represent North America.
So that's 1-0 Europe, right?
Yeah. Yeah. No.
North America.
Oh. Do they still get the round even though Simple wins it?
Yeah.
Oh. Right.
Sadly, that's actually the whole contention here, Red
Eye.
Even when the European player does, in fact, win, the credit goes to North America. You see how this country was built, mate?
You are definitely not getting out of here alive. 1-0 to America, then. On Nuke, the brand new Nuke, of course.
Literally, it's Team America as well, of course. Shroud. Knows where his bread's buttered, mate.
P90's not being effective for Simple this time around. Maybe stick to a pistol. Rain picking up the ugly kill of the round. Tarek will come back. Will he? No, he'll get gunned down as well. Shroud back in for the reply. Shroud with another. Good work from him. And then Get Right makes short work of Skadoodle after making his way all the way round towards heaven now. And he's got himself a weapon. Not for long though. Shroud coming back in yet again. He's picked up three now of the round. And it's a 2v2. Nico knows he's there. Shroud above waiting. A little bit more difficult now into the heaven with that railing there. Okay. Meanwhile,
Nico
has pulled out a shotgun, and we're back to Nico having to clutch. Again, it's not going to work. 2-0. Straightforward conversion from round one for America.
Still quite a costly round there. Like obviously, Simple got wrecked with that P90, but
Nico hasn't felt the feeling of winning a round in quite a while. Too soon. Hashtag too soon. It is on the CT side, though. They did win a lot there.
It's actually good to see him with a smile on his face, though. The guy, we went back in the van like last night with the guys, and like, obviously, a bit sad. Might be an understatement to lose all those match points, but yeah, they're coping pretty well. Had GB James there to give them some.
He gave them some advice. He said, "Listen, guy, life's hard. You know, that's why I like it. It's a challenge."
So can they convert round three? Nothing on the T-side Europeans right now. And they're making short work of this Skadoodle with a couple. And it's time we have Kenny S, who's going to be flooded on the outside area.
All right, so this is the moment of truth.
Indeed. Gun round. Number four.
Keep in mind, everyone's been saying now that it's too T-sided, so I want to see some big things here from Europe. Shut this American crowd up. No, I'm just kidding. Wow. I'll leave that to you. I'll leave the bad guy to you.
Yeah, I'd like one of you to make it home.
Yeah.
At least one.
We need... That's our problem, Paul. We spend too long. We forget who's good cop and bad cop.
Just both
in the Yeah, we just walk in a room like, you're not getting out of here. And then, like, Duncan goes in. Yeah,
he's got a really bad temper, you know. I'd watch what he said. Now he'll be back in a minute.
Okay.
Orps give me that water.
All hopes are in play. Skadoodle taking the pretty traditional spy outside, but Kenny S is going to pick up the first kill. He's got AWP in hand as well, as you'd expect.
Right, in an All-Star game, he gets the AWP, of course. He doesn't have a
shotgun in the hands of Hiko, though. Guns down Nakaletti. He might get another one here. Oh! He does get another one. Headshot from the shotgun of Hiko. Decided not to buy up round three, round four, and has kept the shotgun. Can he find a third here? Meanwhile, Tarek's picked up one. Only two men remain from Europe, Get Right and Rain, and both of them under attack now. Rain does get picked off by Tarek. Get Right, though, comes back in for one more. Can he get the second? He can, and Hiko's gunned down. And now Get Right, after two down and a one versus four, now needs two more in the upper bomb site right now. Can climb up the ladder, of course. That's a new part of this map. And if he's smart enough, he can get even higher than that if he wants to as well. Plenty of options here in the upper bomb site. Bomb not in hand, though. Tarek and Shroud are ready. So what does Get Right
this do? Is the moment where Semler would scream peekaboo when he comes around the corner. Yeah. Of course. So
we were going to pay some homage actually to some of the great casters down there.
Yeah, sorry, we haven't mentioned Semler. Yeah.
But we haven't actually had any. We haven't had any play worse. Well, now we have got to play one here. One. Get Right with a three. 1v1, bomb in a very difficult position. He won't be able to get to it now. He's got to gun him down! And instead, Shroud will win the round. 4-0 America. We've been here before. Mm.
Yeah, you start out strong. Problems closing games, of course, as we've seen.
I mean, Get Right's trying to help out the North Americans by literally giving them the opportunity to zip it up. But they can't do that in real games.
Definitely can't.
Shroud here, just calculating. How much tax is it now? It's like, I'm in the big bag, 40%. Maybe if I start like a charity, I get like a discount on that. I'll probably start one for like wounded North American players from semi-finals.
There's plenty of them in
I've got a friend who needs some help there. Should start a battered team of good players.
Tax starting things off, gets a double. Make that three. Simple following up. This should be a straightforward round. Just the one man remaining, which is Kenny S. He's polished off by Shroud. So 5-0. Straightforward so far from America. I haven't seen any team play whatsoever from the Europeans. Lots of individual skill, but absolutely zero team.
Yeah, it's almost as if they're just sort of waiting, like, who's going to take it in turns to clutch, like, every round, which, that's fine.
Yeah. Kenny, it's your turn this round. Oh, okay, yeah. I'll be last alive.
Yeah. Again. No, he's not used to that in NBA. So Happy's like, that's my job. I'll be the last alive. You four just run into this meat grinder and... I'll be around here making Predator references.
Okay. He's here all week, guys.
If it bleeds, we can kill it. Why not?
Why not, mate?
So what are we going to get here? Get Right in position. Kenny S has made his way up high, so trying to edge around the corner. He can get around that corner, of course, now in Nuke in 2016. Could never do that before. On top and surprise in heaven, of course. So a couple of set flashes coming off here. Wow. Okay. I think someone's been practicing.
You can actually see the thought process though on the map again.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
they have tried to make it more accessible for tees.
And it definitely is as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
Much harder to defend, harder to retake. Kenny S now, as you said earlier, look, what are we going to see? Yeah, we're going to see Simple versus Kenny S.
That's 1-0.
At point blank range, actually. And Simple does pick up that first kill. So, in fact, Michael Lady's also gone. So, three left for Europe. 5-0 down. And that grenade has done a little bit of damage. Difficult to see whether they can actually get this bomb planted, but they are down low right now. Nico's down there as well with the bomb plant, so they do get the plant, finally. And now 3v5.
They're actually in a good position.
They are in a very good position, yeah.
even though they've got the numerical advantage here, if they just hold these positions, and Nico's going to get a kill hit.
Oh, hello. Over the back. Hello. Oh, no! Oh, my goodness. It's Nico, all gone wrong for Nico on Hiko.
Yeah, well.
That's
pandering to the crowd more than you were there from Nico. He's not going to. I'll just throw this round, no problem. Have a 16-0 North America, get your tubes done.
Why not?
It's another loss.
That was a real good position they were in. They should have been able to do it.
Finally got into a bomb site.
Hey guys, it'd be brilliant if the All-Star game was on Nuke, wasn't it? All that back and forth. Oh yeah, 16-0. Great game. Fantastic times.
It's much more T-sided now.
Okay.
16-0.
The whole world is, mate.
Oh.
What is wrong with you?
Wow.
Just commentary on geopolitics. That's what I'm here for, right? Not the game or anything.
Seventh round, America leading 6-0. 90 seconds to go. And Europe have full bore. There is double AWPs in play right now as well. Skadoodle and Simple, both with the AWP. Get right AWPing right now for the T side. No longer AWPing at all, actually, because he's been blown away by Skadoodle. Rich is still recovering.
I'm still creased, mate.
KDS now.
Please, Duncan, I need this. I don't have a YouTube channel, please. Don't take this away from me.
Kenny is back in with another one. Headshot this time on Simple. He's got himself two for the round here. Nico with another one. Kenny with the third. Now, perhaps Europe can clean this one up. They can.
There we go.
Finally getting one on the board at the seventh attempt. 6-1.
Yeah, they're starting to feel each other out a little bit now. You can see they're starting to make use of that outside, pushing around into that main area. So, yeah, they're starting to feel the map out a little bit, which is good.
Yeah, not seeing a huge amount of smoke from the CTs on the outside either.
No one's...
Yeah, they haven't quite figured out where they're going to go just yet.
They're American players. They're not buying those things.
If you got them, smoke them. Definitely game on fight.
Tobacco lobbyist.
Yeah.
Okay. So apparently we've got comms on the guys. I just thought this might be quite a treat. Should we listen in?
Yeah, definitely listen.
Let's listen into the communication then.
I hope Simple's just wrecking them as well.
There is.
We're in hut. Hut killed me. One hut jumped out my window. Out my window. And then in upper.
Squeaky.
No, one aim.
Fuck. What is this shit, dude?
1 minute, mate.
Two minutes.
The hell? You can look through that?
The gap is so big, right?
Yeah. Left, right? Well, yep. glad we got that insight there.
I'm glad they cut it at the end before Hiko said, like, I get paid for that round, yeah? Do I still get paid? The money isn't in my account.
That's why. Yeah. All these people at home are like, it's great when you have the comms. It's not. It's a minefield.
Mm.
You can't do that.
Also, don't put it on Europe. I don't want to hear Kenny. Sacre bleu!
He's never going to say that.
What are you on about? As if that got a laugh.
Listen,
mate, it's dynamite, that is. That's fire. Fire. I come with the farts.
Dribbler. Get out of my face.
All right, round 9. And it is underway. Europe having ball 2. Back! Oh! A double from Michael Ailey.
Was that a double?
Can he make
said
it a triple?
Said
he's
Eco
done that before.
At Burger King. He's the whopper of a lad.
And another one added. Michael Ailey now with 3. Finished off by Shrell, though. Nice little headshot. These two are absolutely wrecked, which is coincidence, really, because America did in exactly, round 9. It's 6-3.
As if they're paying us for this, mate. Don't wreck another player, Duncan, please.
Why not?
Yeah. I'm glad you're here.
Is there anyone you haven't picked on yet?
The good players, obviously. Yeah. So, Europe. No.
It's harder. It's a lot harder to pick on really good players. Yeah. Just play fantastically. Don't have huge egos. And live in Europe. Last part, entirely integral to the process.
It's interesting, a double up set up on T.
Yeah. It's a new strat, it's a new map.
Yeah,
let's try anything, right? Michael Ailey's on there. He's just like, Kenny S is in the background basically telling him he wants to open. He's like, sorry, buddy. I'm open. And it's working out nicely as well. They're on Eco, of course.
Yeah. Simple's got the Zeus out.
I
think we need some Zeus action, don't we?
Yeah.
Same podcast. I think we always wanted to play with Zeus.
We were talking about the voting earlier, right? The fans really missed the trick because you could have put Taco and Simple on the same team here. And you missed it, right? And people, I don't know if they saw the tweet. I think Taco put a tweet out last night, something like, "You mad I am in the final?"
Oh.
There it is.
Simple.
There it is.
A blast to the face with the Zeus, and Kenny S is down.
And he's picked up an AWP as well there, so that's actually very good for him, if he can keep it.
A little bit of back and forth on the squeaky door as well. Tarik now, short range kill.
Isn't that the name of a chapter in your forthcoming biography, Paul?
What's that?
Back and forth on the squeaky door. It's a very personal description of his time and life and times of Paul Chogan. Listen, we've all had a drink.
You speak for yourself.
I was wondering there, Richard. I was going to say, were you looking at him or were you looking at me? As I said when I first met Kenny S.
I thought he said I don't wreck the
good players. I just did.
We're at 6-4 now. America's still winning.
Just get him out of here. Don't want to do this anymore.
Who thought this was a good idea?
That's terrible, isn't it? I can only apologise.
So, five left in the first half. And America do lead.
Sneaking up on him.
Yeah, it's going to try and...
going to make it rain.
This time it does work, and that's the first one it's worked on, actually. Kenny S has tried it a couple of times. Rain now does make it work. Simple, though, has picked up two. Europe now just have the three men remaining.
I'm actually really impressed with how well Simple is playing, because I'm not joking. He was definitely drowning in his sorrows last night.
He's having fun, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Definitely having
fun. That's how good he is.
Right then, Kenny S, Clutchmaster.
And, of course, the concern with the Cloud9 players, maybe they'd be too out of shape, haven't played in a few days.
That just shows how far Cloud9 have fallen. The crowd are applauding. You
Yeah, screw Cloud9.
We are betraying. They have betrayed us by not making it out of the groups. Yeah, brilliant. Got it.
Wow. Nice. There we go. 1v2.
There's a pixel perfect headshot from Kenny S.
Now, it's Kenny S versus two people who think they're really good AWPers. Let's see what he can do here. Seminar coming up later. Apparently all of Europe has to attend a seminar now for bullying Freakazoid. But there's no weather, so we're not going to get tans. And obviously on Steam, we all have friends, so take care of that.
Wow.
1v1 in.
Yep, 1v1 now. Kenny S has pulled this all the way back with 2 seconds. Can't plant the bomb, though. And that's why Hiko's the clutch master and Kenny S isn't. Wrecked. 7-4. 11 down. 4 to go in the first half. America with the lead, as you'd expect, perhaps, on the CT side. We haven't really seen a huge amount of fun, I think. Simple seems to be the only one having a bit of fun in there. I want to see more Zeus.
Hiko running around with a shotgun.
Well, yeah.
Reminds me of deers on the farm. Maybe.
You stay away from my daughter, boy. Sneaking up to steal pies in the window. What is that? Cherry? We're going to do a wholesome series where, like, Hiko's grown up in Kansas or something. Became salary man.
Into the round we go then. Skadoodle has picked up the first one. Rain's made his way inside here. Actually, if you can pick off Skadoodle, that's a difficult angle now from Main, actually, looking up there, isn't it? Much more difficult. Chance. That was a long time until that AWP got fired.
Yep. Delay.
Rain does pick up the kill. Hiko then replying with two. Get right now, last man standing, 1v4 again. And again, there have been so many rounds where Europe have ended up 1v4.
If anyone can do it, boss, it's get right.
Has been known to clutch occasionally.
Yeah.
Oh, that night.
Boom.
Hello. Kobe Bryant.
Retired now, of course.
Still good.
Yeah, not bad. Not bad.
Also never killed a man with an explosive fight. It's beside the point, guys. Beside the point.
Get right now, to finish off the round, does pick up the one.
Yeah, you can imagine Kobe's age. Yeah, they're associating you with grenades for some reason in this game. I don't like that.
Fairly quiet game from Skadoodle here. Actually the only professional Counter-Strike player who passed the Turing test.
That's
two good references, isn't it, Rich? I've wasted on them. Should have said something about X-Machina.
That was weird, though. You know that delay? When he had that delay there, when he was like, he looked like he didn't shoot. Was that just him being...
Just lag.
Slow? Yeah, was it meant to lag? Yeah, exactly. It's getting some insight as to why Cloud9 aren't here.
Well, one thing's for sure, America are going to have a lead at halftime when we switch over.
Rigged.
Do I get points for the most obvious phrase of the day for that?
Possibly.
What would that be then?
Hello. Can Shroud finish this off? He knife. Goes for the knife. Slash. Just a hair's breadth away from claiming the knife kill. Not to beat.
I mean, we would say, well, we are in the All-Star game, but Simple actually did do that in an important round in a real game.
Yeah,
he did. That was a
CLG series. Yeah. That's when you knew he was really feeling it as well, when he went for that.
Mm. Sign of a confident player. Going for. I think Europe are in a little bit of trouble here. They're going to need a couple of rounds. Had this been old Nuke, no problem. 9-4, pretty good. We've got four rounds, guys. We're fine.
Makalela going full gangster. He's going for the going for the NWA drive-by.
I mean, I thought you meant he was going there.
Wow, hello.
I thought you meant he was going full gangster because scoreline's usually 187.
Wow.
Nice. Again, reference incredibly wasted on this crowd.
And if you don't happen to know the codes for murder in police speak, now you do. Well done, Duncan.
As it was murder.
Educate the masses.
Nice to see Gabe Newell there, enjoying the festivities. Hasn't fired me yet. Come on, Gabe. You got any more bullets in that gun, mate?
Give it time.
There is still time. Trust me.
There is still time.
Okay, final round and a half then.
Yeah, be sure to put this game before the final, guys. We don't need any talent for that.
Oh,
nice pick.
Tarek, nice angle, nice corner. Picks up one. Probably should have picked up at least two from that and doesn't.
And back to normal.
Take willing things back up. Nice push on the outside here. Sybil's behind and picks up another Zeus kill. And the frag on the Kenny S replying back. Europe down to two. Nico and Get right now in the upper bomb site. Now it's a 2v1 and Skadoodle now has to clutch for the Americans. Can he do so? It's now a 1v1.
Man alive, that reaction speed. Is that what you're going to play?
Did you really just go there?
I remember when Skadoodle was the bomb. Yo.
Phantoms? Yeah. Listen, mate, you're not going to be good in this tournament, but Skadoodle was the bomb in Phantoms, yo.
Hey, he was the bomb in 2014. not quite so much now.
Well, talking of bombs.
There we go. Got to get a plan.
Nico with the bomb. 35 seconds remaining.
Nice segue there.
Thanks, Doki.
Half the audience came here on segues.
Scoots did, of course. They have to provide one at every event he works.
Oh! Hello! Skadoodle knew exactly where he was coming. And America has the first half, 11-4.
Yeah, well, so much for it being T-sided, I guess. But on a real note, obviously, the American players do look a lot sharper. Simple in particular, just going off, you know, playing without fear. And Makalela. There were a few question marks about his inclusion, and hasn't acquitted himself with glory there. So.
It does look like the European players do bait each other a bit. Like they don't go in together, and they do just go one by one. Like I said, actually, most of the North American players, you have to realize, have played tons of FPL with each other. Yep. Some have been in teams, they've played tons of 10-mans.
Yep. So, I mean, Team America are looking good here, and you can see, actually, all of these people, you know, have got experience with each other before. I mean, a little bit awkward, we haven't even talked about that. Hiko playing with Cloud9 players, you know, that's a bit edgy.
But I mean, only one of them was his teammate, though.
Yeah, true.
The other one, he wanted to be his teammate, but then he left, said, listen, I've got a better idea. I'll join Cloud9. I'll probably work out for both of us. See you in the final one day. He said, no, All-Star game.
And scene. And you can see here, you know, Nico, Kenny S and Getright are phenomenal players. I think Rain and Makalela from FaZe, you know, they're in there because of the social media reach. Rain's been a good player, but he's kind of in a bit of a slump. There's something weird going on in that team.
Yeah.
So it's
very weird after the tweet from Makalela.
Yeah, just like FaZe is just imploding right now, and it's, you know, considering how much money they spent to put this team together for it to kind of collapse so quickly. And I'm devastated because I'm going to bet with Duncan that FaZe we're going to do better than Virtus Pro this year. Well, lost that one as well, haven't I?
It's already over, isn't it?
It's already over.
I think you're done.
It's already over.
Yeah, pay up now.
Did we even have a forfeit for that?
Don't think so.
I think we should.
We never publicly agreed.
Duncan, the word you're looking for is yes.
Oh, wait.
Yeah, no, Duncan, the word you're looking for is yes, we do have a forfeit.
We'll figure it out, yes. We'll have to do something really embarrassing. Like you have to wear like a Cloud 9 jersey in public or something.
get a tan, you man.
I mean,
that's if they do a size big enough.
Respect
right?
for these guys for wearing a Cloud 9 jersey in public. You know, whatever you do with your own life is up to you. Feel proud in your own skin.
It's like that joke, isn't it?
if you don't feel bad, no one can make you feel bad. As I always tell people, as I'm reckoning.
High-ranking politician was found dead in the Cloud 9 jersey, so they came in and put suspenders and stockings and an orange in his mouth to spare him the embarrassment. You know, just saying.
Shout out, Jack. We love you, mate. That was all Richard.
1990s.
Told me to get that in there.
1990s, Tory sleaze, reference game, incredibly on point.
Bethnal Green, wasn't it?
Oh. A couple of stunning little headshots from Nico to start things off then. And maybe there's a little bit of fight left in Europe after all. 11-4 down at the half. Got some work to do in this second half.
Said Woodrow Wilson in 1917.
Oh, come on, guys. Give me a break. I haven't cast it since 1846.
I was going to say, he seems around when Woodrow Wilson was in, was he?
Yeah. I know when you get a Cronenberg, you're like, it's not even that old stuff or anything.
From 1644, this stuff.
Listen, Woodrow, let me tell you about eSports. It's going to be big. We all need visas. Oh, wait.
Last man alive is Hiko. Has clutch plenty. The 1v4 yesterday was one of the finest clutches we've seen. And he can do this. He's got a bit.
Getting shanked.
And it's Nico on Hiko this time round.
A lot of Zeus kills, a lot of knife kills.
See Nico's face there. This is still better than the semi-final. Yeah. He's just happy, isn't he?
I know. Well, he's on T-side. He just got some kills there, boys. Yeah. Do you remember when he used to get kills on T-side? Man. It was a long time ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
It was a long time ago.
Yeah, Nico having a big round there. Two nice headshots and a knife.
Yep, 11-5.
I believe it's a two-piece and a biscuit, they call it in Call of Duty or whatever MLG used to do before they realised.
420 no-scope.
Yeah, something like that.
I tell you what, in real life, you'd never be able to take a two-piece and a biscuit from Nico. he'll go 1v4 versus anyone.
Kenny S going with the AWP in round two of the second half.
Nice.
And using outside nicely. It's exactly where you want to be with that AWP. Over in the old Mac building. I don't know if it still has Mac written on it, actually. Not sure. Didn't check.
All right, so what's Simple going to do here? Can't win the round, but he's obviously going to play for some style points here.
He can win the round.
He's got a gun now.
He can do it. He can do it.
Shotgun.
Die hard, of course. Ho-ho-ho, now I have a machine gun. Reference game on point.
Yeah. John McClane is a hero.
He's actually got a lot of time to play with.
Yes, he's got plenty to do. You can have a lot of fun here. Shotgun versus shotgun. Simple wins that one. Does take a lot of damage though, and Get Right will finish him off. Frustration on the face of Simple.
He's loving it.
He actually is complaining in an old style game. What are you doing? I was dead, mate. Idiot. Literally talking trash to a Dren in team say, not even in the game. What are you doing? You're paid to play like this?
Oh man, you went on him so hard. Like, seriously, Arjun, I stole him.
I love a Dren too, man. Big fat Gambit fan.
Unreal.
No, I see it.
Right.
Got a boost coming
nice
in
boost
here.
Oh.
And that is the KS of old.
Yeah, and that's two in a row he's done that. I think they need to learn that he's going to be there quite often.
Nico's going off in this game, boss.
Yeah, it's called a UMP. It's exactly the same thing, really, for him. And Kenny S, this time, picks out Skadoodle. This should be straightforward. He came with the last man alive again. Dispatched by Get Right.
So about it being T-sided then, guys?
Yeah, so much for that theory, right? It's good, though. At least we're going to get a close game. And possibly a European victory.
Are you still holding on to that? America are favourites in this game, right?
Well...
We were discussing this before, because they do mix a lot, right?
Yeah,
a lot more than we do in Europe.
Or Yeah, I think I think they've got the slight advantage. I definitely think so. Mm. But still, I want us to get something out of this.
Yeah, do you?
Yeah. I said, think about the tournaments Kenny S and Get Right have had. They deserve something, right?
Small confirmation backs, but say what you want about All-Star Games being far more enjoyable. I'm pretty sure all 10 players want to win it.
It's just a bit of bragging rights, isn't it? Obviously, all these players talk to each other and all hang out backstage.
There's a bit
stuff.
Of smack talk afterwards as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
remember that time when I knifed you three times in the same game? Remember that time I knifed you three times?
Should have made it interesting and put some money on the line. That's what motivates these guys.
Put your money where your mouth is.
Mm. Yeah, exactly.
Exactly.
Well, you two feel free.
Okay.
Mate. You don't need to tell
personally,
about
Richard,
that.
I wouldn't have suggested introducing gambling components to CSGO. I mean, I'm big friends with Valve, you know. And I know you just say, I flaunt their rules, and no one will ever catch me because I'm the only one who does the investigations. So, who watches The Watchmen, eh, Richard?
Who does watch The Watchmen?
No one. It was a rubbish film.
Yeah.
It was
bad adaptation.
34. 3v3, round 19.
Rorschach on point.
It was way too long and it got painful at the end. Also another chapter from the Paul Redeye Chalice story. So, again, a lot of personal insights in that. A lot of anecdotes, a lot of stories.
I thought you were talking about the Team Liquid game.
It was also about his time at ESL.
Oh, that's a book right. Many years.
Too soon, hashtag too soon.
Way too soon.
Way too soon, yeah.
Hello, Blake. And let's pick up the last two. So, another round on the ball for the Europeans. Now slowly putting it back. Hinko looking a little bit concerned now. He's actually dishing out some orders.
Oh, yeah, he's been here before, hasn't he? He's been here before.
He's lost without GB James, of course. He's sat there. He's flaccid. He's in an entirely normal, neutral state of mind.
Yeah.
He's not even sexually excited. How's he supposed to play Counter-Strike like that, Richard? You need top-quality coaching in this game.
Hey, on a serious note...
Of course, Shroud, knowing he's playing just for the fans. Incredibly hard.
Yeah, I'm telling you, on a serious note, I thought GB James has done all right this time. Apart from not taking that time out. I'm gonna give him some props, man.
Apart from 0 T rounds or whatever it was. The only part of the game that actually references a coach, but aside from that, very well done.
Getting right with the opening kill on the round. And again, Europe looking just to
looking like another European round, eh?
Yeah. Pull it back.
But will America C4? Put the bomb down.
That's terrible.
That was quite bad.
You're turning this into a League of Legends broadcast. Yeah. Say the word that sounds like the other word, Duncan. Puns are great. We're allowed to do these.
Single bullet from Michael Laney now looking back towards radio. And does get the kill onto Tarik. Pick up a number of kills here, actually. They're all trying to flood in towards that radio room. They're all trying to run through. Getright picks up the first and the second.
Also notice there's your favourite chant in the crowd, the Makalele. You do like that, don't you?
The Macarena? Yeah.
No. It's not a 90s disco now, Paul. There you go. Duncan actually does get mega tilted if you do that, by the way, guys. So if you want to keep doing that throughout the game, it will put
on. I know.
Up.
I was watching, actually, a news Thank report, you. And I heard some guy from the Middle East doing something like that. I was like, there's even fans out there. Reference game, too edgy.
You've already gone too far, I think, in this broadcast.
Back to the game. Things are closing up, of course. 11-9 now, so just the two between. Europe on the comeback trail and on the CT side. A little bit of advantage here. A little bit more organised, I think, as well.
Tell you what, right? Come on, Duncan. Show these play-by-play casters how it's done. Come on, I want to hear you do some play-by-play. You just sat there, slumped in your chair, thinking, now I'm going to insult another player. All right, come on, do some play-by-play. I want
to
hear
you. It's only the beginning of the round, though. You have to wait till something starts to happen, right?
No. You don't get that luxury.
Coming outside here. Coming. Shroud up on the catwalk, up above everyone else, walking, doing his little turn like a model. Right said Fred references, but Simple gets a kill outside. Get Right goes down, not for the first time, probably not for the last time. Moving out here towards Secret. Is it a secret? Not a secret anymore. It's not Victoria's secret. It's KDS's secret. And he's looking, can he see him through the wall? Of course not. That's the X-ray mode. If he had X-ray specs, tell you what, he'd look at his hand in an old 1960s comic. DC Comics Code reference game on point.
See, I like that.
Stack references together, mate. Yeah.
I mean, you can also say what's going on. Is there a timer?
Nah, don't do it.
Why are we on camera?
Why are you going to do that?
What's happening here?
You just say things that you think are funny.
Oh, is that it? Is that the secret casting?
Apparently, yeah. Anders told me.
Oh. Wow.
You can get back in if you want, Paul.
No, no, I'm good. You carry on.
Also, another chapter in Paul Red Eye, Tom.
You can get back in.
That was about his return to casting. These chapter headings are dynamite, by the way. I can't wait to read the book.
The pacing was a little bit off.
It was.
And the intonation wasn't quite there. Okay. And your projection was a little low. Okay.
There you go.
You could work on that. Funny
out.
Right.
Yeah, there's only say see in the comments right there. Tell you what, you get a shot here, son. Take a bow. Take a bloody bow. You know what? Give him the service medal. He's only bloody gonna done it for his teammates, hasn't he?
See, that's much better.
He's like Nobby Styles the way he moved around. Wow. The
See, only I've got that because the only person in this entire room.
It's like a young Glenn Hoddle, the way he always creates space for himself. Tell you what, he's going to become a hell of a player. Speaking of a hell of a player, Nico.
Nice seg.
Brilliant, mate.
He's pretty good, isn't he? It's
not bad.
Not bad.
He could do it. Look, I've always said I wanted to do like a series of casts. For games where it's just like me and Orange just straight wrecking people. I think that'd be good. I'd like to do it. Yeah. Obviously, I wouldn't let him do play-by-play in that one, though. So,
right.
He's terrible.
Anyway, all that going on,
yeah.
Reminder of the score,
yeah,
America
12-9.
Did actually win that round, so, you know, chance of closing this out now.
He knows.
Your fans are obnoxious. You're criticising Makaleli. Fans are just shouting, Dorin, say something.
Mate, even I hate my fans. Wait, what's wrong with them?
You've trained. All right, there we go, 12-10.
Yep, Tarek not able to clutch that one.
What's the economy looking like now? Or is this going to be another eco?
The economy for North America, of course, in the toilet. China owns most of their stock in the game.
it's a bit
that's why we need a businessman as a president.
We need a war is what we need, Richard. A real bloody war.
I was saving that for the end. I was going to get
Black war, of course.
Tell you what, even when North America's low on funds, don't worry, guys, the black budget, incredibly large.
Yeah.
CIA, agent, Area 51. Shall we leave the country, Rich? Shall we do that?
I think you'd be lucky to get out of it, frankly.
I'm feeling like going on a little trip to Guantanamo Bay in Cuba, actually, so get some sun after this thing.
I might have some important paperwork for you filed at the moment.
I'm all right, Rich. I'm right, yeah.
Let's dial it down. Shut it down.
Get right getting a little bit edgy here. Might pick up one, though. Shut down easily inside that radio room. Simple reply on that one. Now Europe find themselves a man short. A little bit pushy there.
Last time
I saw
such an inevitable simple reply as that, Semler was replying to something Anders just said. So, not such a great duo, of course. Overpaid. Oh, sorry, I'll get back to the game. Love those guys.
No longer your fans.
Nah. It's over. All that stuff about all the casters and everything getting along together, it is just.
Just a web of lies.
We just do it for the fans, really.
I mean, I once saw Anders punch Moses in the balls just for saying one of his catchphrases.
I know.
I said, that's bang out of order, that is. I said, Anders, are you kidding me? While I covered my own balls, of course.
If you've
learned one thing, cover your balls when you're around Anders.
And we haven't managed to fit many of those in yet, by the way, properly.
True.
But then, like Anders said to me this morning, you need the shots to be out of corner.
Okay, let's go through the classics. And we'll go as the scenarios.
Do you want to start right at the very beginning?
When they present themselves, we'll come up with one.
Okay,
we won't force them though.
All right. Okay.
Unlike Anders, of course, we'll actually make them where they apply.
There has been a very slow paced game.
It has, actually. I was going to say that.
You can see, there hasn't been a lot of rushing, apart from on like sort of the eco rounds. You can see, like, obviously, they're not going to have a lot of tactics here. Yeah. But I would have thought the Europeans in particular would have maybe, you know, tried to pull out a few more style points. North Americans being typically more flamboyant there.
Yeah. Yep, since simple with the double Zeus so far, a couple of knife kills. But that's been about it. Hello, Nico with two. Going to get third, going to fourth. No, not quite. Rain picks that one up. But three of the swag, seven kills, and Michael A will finish them off. So we're tied up at 12-12.
There also hasn't actually been a lot of rounds where someone got like four kills or three sensational kills, you know, so we haven't had a lot of opportunity.
No.
That's the problem with Nuke, though. That actually was the problem with the old map as well. It's that when the terrorists lose numbers and there's all the CTs left alive, no one wants to be the one to go in. Then you just go slowly one by one and die. So actually, that's why I was joking, but it's not so ideal for an all-star game.
No. I mean, when I'm playing with my team, which is...
Tell us more. Never
Hang on a minute.
Stories before, guys.
What
I saw that.
What was that sign?
I saw that sign. Security, confiscate that sign. We're not allowed to talk about the incident.
Okay, here we go.
Move along.
Big.
Nico, yeah, picking up another one with that Mag 7 yet again. Tarik replying back, though. We're almost equal now. Just a man deficit here for the Europeans again. It's closed up. And we finally seen a bomb plant. Like, it's like about the third bomb plant we've seen in 24 rounds.
Yeah. Well, I don't think they've even forgotten that you have to plant the bomb in this game. They're just sort of running around shooting each other, which obviously is what you want from an all-star game. But Makelele, I've got to say, he's been a little bit of a liability for you.
He's been quiet as well. Yeah,
well, I think, what's he on? Is he on like 8 kills? Yeah. You bring that up?
It was 8, I think, yeah. Yeah, it is 8. Yeah.
So he's right down the bottom. Everyone
tell
else
you what,
is
Richard,
putting in a shift.
After this game, he's going to be looking for a new team.
Yeah, I know, yeah. FaZe are thinking,
that's a really strong prediction, that is. Yeah, isn't it? It's a really strong prediction.
FaZe like, thank God.
Getright's busted out the auto sniper.
Yeah, but just going to save here. Obviously, two expensive guns.
Is Anders observing this?
Tarik actually, before he died, he had actually swapped out the Swag 7 for an AK. Of course, if Paul was in the green room, he'd have said, listen, Swag 7, is it viable? Probably not. In my games, though, I'll tell you what, sometimes I surround by it. Fall off a box, kill two people. What are you going to do? You know. As they always tell me, listen, Paul, you're a brilliant bloody FPL player, but why are you always messing around with those guns? Why don't you play the meta? I said, listen, the meta wasn't around when I was playing.
For those that don't know,
I said, listen, Goose, man, it's a nice idea for a game, but will it ever be Quake? That's all I'm going to say. I said, of course, I'm going to have to get out of the casting game now. A bit long in the tooth. I've heard Warcraft 3 is coming out soon.
Yeah. Right.
Sorry. Everyone gets it. Everyone gets it.
Brutally and savagely.
Okay, Richard, you have to do it. If they do a synchro, you've got to bring a casting gem out, okay?
You got to bring a gem?
Be like, all right. Will it be a toss pop?
The problem is, whenever I do play-by-play, I just sound like one of them like drunken
just
horse
try
race
and do
guys.
If there's like a three kill, just try and do one of the classic reactions.
Okay. Right. You've got to wait for it, though.
Another chapter from the fourth gun biography.
So, yeah.
Which you've got to wait for as well, so.
This
available in, I'm looking forward to reading
available
your book
in 20
years.
Available in the remaining Woolworths.
and petrol stations.
At half price.
All signed, amazingly. All signed.
All hand signed and half price.
So you can see Nico's speaking of, on the outside.
Speaking of half price players, Tarik died very early on there. Yeah. And, you know, you get what you pay for.
You do.
As the phase owner never says.
I think Makelele just wants to get out of here. Like, just start hunting for that too.
This life? Or
No. Just this game. Just this game. Keeps making these ridiculous leaps. Like, here we go, Nico's actually.
Nico's got it.
Yeah, Nico's been absolutely crazy.
Well, this is the thing. Like, people don't realise it's not just. It isn't just a meme. Like, Nico is actually that good.
Yeah, very, very good. Yeah.
He does belong in an all-star game. It's not like some fan pick.
24 right now. Yeah, Getright has 23. Kenny has 21. Rain 19. And Makelele 8.
Well,
simple 23 on the other side. No one else over 20. But it is 14-12, and America are two away.
Yeah, they're actually gonna. Get someone to
Rich,
get the crowd
pumping.
No,
don't do it.
I'm not going to say that. These fans have obviously been, you know, great all weekend, and you know, since we got into the stadium, so yeah, they do deserve something to cheer about.
The thousands of fans here, and the millions.
And the millions. Well, actually, it's amazing.
Billions.
So there is millions.
Billions in the stadium.
The trillions watching on Mars. CIA conspiracy plus. Face on Mars.
Nico on the land and not able to pick up that first one. Heading in the second frame now from above. Tarik in with a reply though. America moves closer. Makelele and Getright now combining. They've got Makelele remaining and has got a huge amount of work to do here. Tarik actually is a little bit low, so he might be able to pick up one here.
Yeah, well, I know where I'd put
my money. Hoping. Yeah. All Simple's to no avail. Simple takes them to match point.
America a match point.
In the All-Star game.
Where did the USA chance today?
Yeah, let's get one going, guys.
Where's the USA?
Do a USA chant, everyone.
No?
What? Not a patriot?
Are you not don't you love your country?
Jesus.
Terrible.
Shocking. Shroud wants to hear a USA chant. It'll really get him going.
Nah, it's not happening. There you go. One guy's
you've
doing
been
it.
Wrecked.
Love that guy.
USA!
There we are. Wow, is that pulling bloody teeth?
Oh, Kenny S has put Simple to bed. Yeah. America need four.
He was doing that last night, literally, of course.
He was.
Come on, Simple.
Literally.
Get away from the bar.
Nico. Right.
Nico again.
Hello.
I haven't even seen him like use the Mag 7 like this, like in professional.
Never seen him, no.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Well, like a lady coming right
now. Here we are.
Just use shotguns on Nuke, that's obviously the strat.
Game's alive.
Yep, game's alive. So.
Some sort of plow strat.
That's the other thing. Even though Nico has like the same amount of kills as Get Right almost, he has got loads of his kills like knife, shotgun.
Yeah.
Yeah, pistols, yeah. Yeah, he's been all over the place.
No, I mean, he's a really versatile player. And like, is Deagle playing insane, pistol play insane, can AWP, can rifle, like.
Speaking of versatile players, Skadoodle, he actually played for Curse, and he played for IBF Power, and he played for Cloud9, so versatile player. He's done a lot in his career, can I tell you?
So, just an AK on Tannic right now. The rest all on a save.
Looking like we could be going to overtime here, boys.
Oh, not an OT.
I haven't had enough of those this week.
I know, innit?
Actually, I think that might have been a mistake.
Oof. Oh, there
a
it
big
is!
Big mistake now as Shroud comes in with the slash on Kenny. It's going to be
Hiko
too little too late as Nico picks up Hiko. That was a play pigeon shot down there.
I mean, obviously, it's all fun and games, but if it does go to overtime, I feel like Simple and Hiko might get a little bit triggered, guys.
Yeah.
What are they actually... No, listen. What are they actually doing in an overtime situation for this? Because you can't have the All-Star game potentially run over forever.
I think on the big speaker, they just say, everyone lost. Go home, please, everyone. Please don't litter.
There are no winners.
Yeah.
The war is over.
Yeah. It's 15-14, so match point for America in the All-Star game.
See what the way American team's throwing away match points here.
Hold your breath, everyone.
Which will not do.
Well, this would actually be bad for the crowd, I think. I don't think they'd enjoy this at all. I think, but surely you settle OT, they just have a knife fight or something.
Like a
1v1 mid.
Yeah, why not, right?
Yeah. How should all be sound.
Of course, they've got to get to overtime first, of course. But
might do so. Ooh, Get Right. Picked up one. Couldn't get the second. He can reply. And now Rain got control of this upper bomb site and does pick up the first and the second. Nicely done. Can't get the third. Shroud now is alone. 1v3.
There we go.
For all the marbles.
Oh, if this was FPL.
Oh, my goodness.
The round would already be over.
Oh, he's going to do it, though. Yeah. Checked him already. He's going to have a chance at this.
He can get this kill coming.
See if he can find the first.
There's one.
Did get one. Can he get a second? No, he can't!
Overtime.
And triggered.
Oh, it's kind of fitting Nico gets the last kill to send it to overtime.
And it's 15.
So how many rounds did everyone actually get on the T set? Was it like three or something?
Four.
Oh, four. Okay, so yeah.
So about the same.
So about that battle, guys.
Yeah, yeah.
Very, very T-sided map now.
Pretty much analysis. Not on point at all. We don't know what
But we're learning about Nuke.
Yeah, which is the main thing.
As many of these players are.
Oh, there's that sign again. Security, please. Please get rid of it. Don't read it, Paul. Because it'll be in your brain.
I think that's Mekon out of isn't that a poster of Mekon out of Dandare?
How are the sales of the Brutal Savage Wrecked
t-shirts? Well.
Yeah, going well, I think. Going well. Yeah. Going well.
You nearly had some as well.
Yeah.
So? Yeah, I didn't do your size.
If you guys are out there looking for some merchandise, it is a cafe press, so you can get yourself a Brutal Savage Wrecked thong, Brutal Savage Wrecked deodorant.
I'll tell you what, if you're wearing a thong
Here's
around
question,
Red Eye,
though, Red Eye,
you are going to get Brutal Savage Wrecked.
Is there a Brutal Savage Wrecked bow tie? That's my question.
Sadly not.
No.
Sadly not.
No. You missed the trick there.
You're right.
That one spins round when he tells his jokes. They all get out of jail. The old flappy dicky bow.
So 15-0. Are we actually going to do this?
Yeah, I don't even know. Like, I don't think anyone planned for this contingency. No. So.
Okay, so we are going to have.
We are really doing this.
We are going to find a winner.
We've just heard from the director. He's like, yeah, we're doing it. Strap yourselves in, boys. 50 overtimes. It should be knife only.
Yeah. One round, knife only, winner decides.
Yeah, ask the crowd. Do you want to see a knife only round to settle this? Yeah? Yeah? Right. Director, the crowd have spoken.
I mean, it has to be Simple versus Nico if we look at the game.
Yeah.
These are the guys who've got the knives. And
yeah, send out your champion.
One Zeus, a knife. That's all they're allowed.
Yeah, come on, guys.
Or a Zeus fight. 1v1 Zeus fight.
That's going to be a bit hard.
And you only have one shot.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly.
See, what happens if they both miss?
It's like a French duel, you know. If you miss, you reload. Your second comes in.
Okay.
1700 dueling reference game. On point.
Incredibly on point, mate.
I don't think we're allowed to make the rules as we go along.
No, this is.
I
come
don't
on.
Think, I don't think we're allowed to.
We want the knife round. That's what we're here to see. There you go, knife round or riot.
Neither of those options are good.
Security, throw out that kid. Throw that kid all the way out.
He said the R word. Remove him from the premises.
Yeah, and stamp on his sign on the way out as well. Yep. Did that go out live?
Listen, guys, don't leave any signs on the floor when Richard's around.
Oh, God. Stop.
So anyway, do my mambo next week.
Can't wait for you to be the best man at my wedding, Torrin.
That's anyway. Actually a warm-up on my speech right there.
Beautiful play by Tarek down the stairway on Nico to start us off.
That was almost a stairway to heaven like when I was a young man and that song came out.
I thought, this place is going places if that young bottom can keep his habits under control.
We all know that bloody ended. Dead now, of course.
So listen, bottom, keep up. I'm on doubles here. Darts reference, of course.
180. Brilliant. Oh! So, the no scope from Kenny S. Ken Wright picks up another one.
There we go.
So, America winning the first. We are going to play through, I think, all of the overtime rounds. So, first to 19.
I just feel sorry for the Team Liquid players. Mm. It's like, even if it is a bit of fun, you know.
Yeah, this is too soon, right?
Yeah, isn't it? Definitely.
Yeah, too soon. Genuinely feel for them.
I mean, yeah, fair play to them, though. They've took it on the chin like an absolute champ. Mm.
No, and they're playing again.
Why is someone holding a tiny effigy of Scoops and shaking it around? That's just inappropriate.
No, it was actually Scoots.
You know, I once said to Scoots, Scoots, you're kind of like the esports Yoda. He said, what, because I'm kind of like, why isn't that? I was like, no, just wizened, old. And I think they're going to use CGI to use you in the next one, mate.
Boo!
Can we all have a boo for Scoots? Boo! Scoots, boo!
No.
Lots.
Oh!
Boo, what? Scoots! Boo
that's,
him!
That's what you're doing!
What are you doing?
We've got to work with him on the day. Hey, did you like that All-Star game, Scott? Did you like that?
Oh, he is a legend, though.
Yeah, he is. He is. There we go.
Yeah, we love Scoots.
We do love Scoots. We do. Not unreal.
We only say mean things because we like it.
Yeah, exactly.
Like me and Adrian. So.
I wonder what the percentage of the game we've actually covered today is.
I don't know.
Here we go.
Pretty low, right?
Get around with a couple here. He's got a brace so far.
Are we going to get... Oh.
Yes!
Oh, okay. At least they know my name,
yeah,
mate.
Boots on the other foot now. Right.
They know my name, mate.
Yeah, that's true. It's like they're holding this major in Brazil, mate. Hostile crowd.
I always wanted to experience the Katowice crowd, but I feel like now I've got kind of a taste of what it would have been like if I'd gone on that day one. You know? Can we get the crowd to do a huge cover? Come on, guys. No. Learning other languages as we go.
So, final round of the first half of overtime. And we are tied up, so who has the advantage going in? Ideally, Europe, because they're on the CT side. If they don't, then I think America would be in a very good position to win this All-Star game.
And we've seen it so far, how incredibly hard it is to hold the outside area, actually, because obviously it's so open. Even if you're in the warehouse, they can just come over the top.
Yeah, it's much
harder. It actually makes me wonder what would happen if you had this as a competitive game, because I think it'd be very hard to figure that out.
I don't think you can play Max the way you would do before with the AWP, where you were relatively safe.
When do you think this will get reintroduced in a competitive?
I asked Shroud, he said about 3 months ago, so... Pro players always know what they're talking about.
I think maybe there was more wishful thinking. Like,
then again, Shroud told me nothing was becoming the in-game leader of Cloud9. Another lie.
And see.
Why isn't Stewie QK in this game?
Yeah, no,
where is he? I'd like to see him do that in an All-Star game.
Yeah.
I'm trying to, mate. Just keeps coming around.
So we are heading.
Here we go. Spotted.
Here we go.
And that's the bomb. So Europe advantage.
Mm. Advantage Europe from the first half, as you'd expect. Yeah. Picking up two of the three.
11 kills though for Makaleli.
Yeah, well.
11 kills.
It's incredible.
I'm just going to put this out there. I don't think he's in particularly the best place.
Doesn't look like he cares,
right,
does he?
Yeah. No. And I don't blame him either. I mean, he's having a tough time. Geraint's on 34, by the way.
So now we know that we need to have substitutes as well for All-Star games. Things we're learning on the fly here.
I think what we've learned is just don't vote back Lely into All-Star games. Square brackets when he's feeling depressed. Remove if optional.
Yeah, 34 kills getting right, 31 for Nico, 26 for Kenny S, and 24 for Rain.
Someone with
Slovakian flag there.
And on Slovakian?
Here we go. What have we got there? Loving that face. That's awesome.
Look at the new Liquid logo. Yeah.
That is classic.
New Liquid logo there.
Whoever came up with that sign, get yourself, I'll buy you a drink. Awesome.
I mean, they really did encompass Team Liquid, the spirit of I Buy Power, with those two incredible throws.
Yeah, I think, you know. Yeah.
Historical reference game on point. Valve specifically asked me to mention that during the Major at some point.
Thorin. We've had issues with Thorin before.
I know.
Thorin is an ass, and we're never working with him again.
Yeah, well,
unfortunately, though.
Don't think we need to worry about that, guys.
luckily, though, people have learned. Don't banter with me over social media, because, listen, there'd be a response from me as well. It wouldn't be a very measured, long speech. It'd be tweets. So, listen, Gabe, let's not get crazy, mate.
Makaleli, you can see what he thinks of
it. But he is doing one of his faces. He is good at doing those funny faces. Come on, give us another one. Will he oblige the crowd? No, just...
Come on. Smile.
There we
give
go.
Give us a smile. There
the way go. He contorted his face
there
like Baryshnikov in his prime.
Yeah.
He's doing Kenny S's eyes. Listen, he's having some fun with his teammate. I like it. I think it's sound, if you ask me. It's all safe as houses, as the MYM League of Legends player said. Shout out to Corey.
All right, come on, let's get this. So what's the pause for?
Tactics chat.
They can't be talking
probably
tactics
a technical
in
problem. Now, Hiko had to adjust his wallet there. He actually uses his wallet as, like, the mouse cord holder, and it's very, very full. So sometimes it'll get out of position, and he can't budge his mouse over again. Look at it. Mm. Look at that thing. The wallet, obviously. Look how bulging it is.
There it is.
Tearing at the seams of the clothing. And there's the wallet.
So much Skrilla.
I know. I haven't seen a man just roll in Skrilla that much since myself.
I was thinking it's a Scrooge McDuck, but...
They wouldn't know that would be reference game
Scrooge McDuck, I would be amazing.
Basically, that intro to DuckTales is like Hiko in the morning getting up. He just does it and he jumps into the pool of money.
Has a swim.
That's actually the Greek myth of how Hiko became such a great clutch player. His mother took him and held him by the ankles and dipped him into a pool of pure Skrilla. And then only his Achilles heel could be damaged, which obviously was his love for his teammates.
Yeah.
In the end, it was love that killed the beast, Richard.
Now you sound like Sadakis. Now you sound like Sadakis.
Listen, Taylor's old as time.
Yeah. Let's get...
I'm surprised you didn't make more of that, actually. Anyway, last three rounds, potentially, of the game, of course, because we could end up with another overtime, I suppose. It's 17-16 to Europe. The Americans now switched over to the CT side. Tarek holding upper. Along with Hiko, Shroud is currently in ramp room.
Oh,
and Kenny S is picking out Skadoodle from heaven.
Which, to be fair, that would have been an accomplishment last year, maybe. Yeah. Easy now, of course.
Of course, you won't see Skadoodle in heaven for a while. Up there on cloud nine. But, you know, very much come down, back down to earth, Rich.
Yeah.
David Bowie reference. Man who fell to earth. He knows.
He knows.
He knows. Listen, I'm trying to, mate. The game won't end. This is my idea of hell. Where's my Twitter?
He hasn't been able to tweet for at least an hour now. He's getting withdrawal symptoms. Shroud now with a couple. Kenny S and Michael Lady now trying to make their way into the lower bomb site. One man is down there already. Kenny S trying to cover him from the back, both with orbs.
Yeah,
it's completely the wrong way. Oh, through the door. A little damage done. And is Michael Lady going to try and chase him down? He is. And meanwhile, Kenny's going to try and get this bomb planted in the smoke. 3v2.
Definitely going to get it down. So, and they're both.
Oh, oh.
Ran straight into the welcome wagon, though, and that's two. That. So simple. Cleans it up.
It does, and we'll be all square again.
17-17.
Yeah, I'm disappointed, you know. We haven't been able to get in any historic favourite phrases. I really was looking for that wham bam shazam moment.
Aren't we all, Paul?
famous last words.
Yeah. It's 10 to 2. You're in the nightclub. Yeah. Looking for some wham bam shazam. Not like shazam.
Wham bam, thank you, man. Wrong type of club.
Yeah, no. Yeah, let's not do that. Some very early commentators that would use some very interesting phrases. That was one of them.
Who actually coined that?
That was Warwick.
It was Warwick.
Yeah. The Castle Orphans.
Missed. He was awesome.
Yeah, he was great.
Talking about him like he's dead. I'm sure he's still.
No, he's still out there.
He had that voice. I'll try and do it in his style. He was like. Coming in at the what's the tone of it? It's something like
wow, that was so bad.
What was that one?
I'm trying to think of what the tone of his voice was.
Painkiller, when he was doing Painkiller.
Yeah, what would
he do? We'll come back
to that. He did like the really American voice, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
Coming in at the red. I can't do that. So it's been a long time since I've heard his voice.
Tough crowd.
Problem is, they wouldn't know who it is anyway.
Get right, okay. It's been.
There's nothing to cast, mate.
Get right, sneaking around on the outside there. He's done this.
Lane's gonna have a chance here.
Yeah, here we go.
But does he know that the guy's back? They're gonna
crab
presumably bolt team in a second anyway. So let's see what he can do.
This is gonna put. No.
Get right on a 1v4 right now.
Put America in the lead now.
The first.
And there we are.
Here we
match
are.
Point.
Match point again.
This time it's the other way around.
Double overtime. Coming in.
Yeah.
Double Could overtime. Be. And get that knife round ready.
I mean, Higo's gonna be sitting there thinking, come on.
What is that guy doing?
Which one?
The one in the American bodysuit.
All right.
Keeps doing electric boogaloo. It's unreal. Yeah, don't hold the USA flag upside down. Although we're all in distress at the moment during this broadcast. So
here we go then. Final round of the first overtime, at least. Anyway, we might even be heading for a second one right now. America needs this round, and we'll. Claim the All-Star game, the first ever All-Star game of the majors. It's Kenny S to start things off, though. Michael Lady falling back up.
It's happening, guys.
Oh my goodness. Now,
oh, no.
Two back from Skidoo and Simple, though. 3v3, that would burn up on high.
Probably should have thrown that smoke onto there.
And look at Simple coming around here. Nice. Oh, this could be really, really nice. Bomb has been planted now. And the retake now has to come in. Skidoo up high, Simple waiting. Inmate's going to be joined by Tarek. They're going to push together here, or not. One in Squeaky, one in Hutch. It's Kenny S who does get the first bit of damage done. He's not going to win the battle, though. Simple somehow wins that one. Nico's come back round behind and finished off Simple as well.
Here it is.
Oh my goodness, Nico with a triple. And we've tied back up at 18-all. You didn't want to watch the grand final anyway,
guys,
did
seriously,
you?
Seriously, if you want to get out here, get to the final. Knife. That's all champ knives. Get the knife from going.
Is it good to have a Bay crowd shout knife, Richard?
I haven't really thought about it.
Just saying.
Did need more thought.
Yeah.
And obviously, if we do get the knife round, what should have to happen is the other players should have to all be in the server as well, but surround them in a circle so they can't escape. And then we will just do that chant of...
No one Listen. Watched original William Shatner Star Trek.
That was one of the early episodes as well, wasn't it?
I'll wager 500 quat loose on a newcomer.
It's good, right? That was a legendary scene, right? Reference game, incredibly on point.
I feel like I'm fighting the Gorn right now. This is unreal. But yeah, come on. We've got to have a knife round, guys. A lot of these players, sure, they're enjoying being in an arena.
You know when you were a kid, careers, and if you didn't have a lot of money, you grew up in a working class background, your mum would cut your hair with a bowl on your head. Actually, Nico's mum only had, those tins for making bread. banana bread. So you got to, listen, you make do with what you can in those times. You scrape together. We've all been there, Rich. We've all had a haircut by our mums. Then you go in the next day, everyone's saying, hey, banana bread, Ed. You go, oh, bloody hell. I am sick at this game, though. They go, nerd. Because you see, gaming wasn't as big back then. Wasn't mainstream.
I think it's a nice haircut myself. A little bit envious.
Yeah, it's all right. It's not bad.
At least he has.
He has got some locks.
Yeah, at least he has a style.
Tell you what. It'll be sad to leave those locks behind, Richard, like P. Diddy.
So, just so people get an update here.
Too good for you there.
The producer says we are fighting to get this knife round up and going. Because you... See? The question is, how do you do with a knife round? There you
Everyone
go.
Do a knife what? Motion in the air as well. Knife, 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 right. Knife. Do the knife motion! Do the knife motion! Stab people! Do the knife motion! It's my dream, Richard. I'm going to take over this country now, mate.
And it's going to be another serious OT, so...
Not more Counter-Strike.
Someone's going to have to step this up.
I've never said this when I've been watching an American team before, but can someone just lose already?
So we are back into OT2 then. Again, America switches over to the CT side. Already picked up two.
Right. I'm gonna have to take over this broadcast, I think.
Do it.
Need to get some meaningless play-by-play on.
We haven't had enough of that.
Yeah.
Being too much meta-contextual, pop culture references, mainly from the 60s to the 70s.
Hey, steady on. It wasn't quite that early.
Come on, I mean, Richard made one literally to 1920s Dan Dare the other day.
Yeah, I know.
And then wondered why even Scoots didn't know what he was talking about.
Point blank range shot from Kenny S does miss the no scope. So Tarek's picked that off, and we're back to Nico on his own again.
Now, this would be incredible, obviously, if he could pull this off. Yeah. He's going to have a chance at the first one, though. Did he see the first guy up there?
Yeah, he did.
But he's purposely not doing it. He's playing poker, as they say, in the CIS region. There's one, there's two. Can he make it a third? He doesn't know where the other two are, though. That's what he's worried about. 30 seconds left, though. That's the problem, obviously.
Yeah, he's got the bomb, though.
He's going to have to go pretty quick. Sadly, I think he's just waiting to see if he can
kill them. Yeah, he's trying to game them here. See if he's going to get the peek out of main. There it is. Shroud picks it up, so down on the board for America again.
Tell you what, the way he was trying to game the system there reminded me of when Bush and the Diebold voting machines. Early 2000s, conspiracy theory reference game on point there, Rich.
just accuse the country.
Do a recount. Do a recount, that's all I'm saying. It's not too late.
All right, Michael Moore.
If there was a recount...
Well, you've got to try and take all three rounds here on the CT side and then hope they can take one on the T side. I mean, I still think it is a lot easier.
It's definitely easy. Yeah. I mean, you can see that from the shoot.
I know they're just standing a bit
but actually, it looks like.
Well,
I mean, you can see how also easy it is to shut down.
Looking very good for the CT, so.
Yeah, I think the reason everyone was complaining about it was just because, you know, it was a new map and people were literally just sort of five man rushing and
stuff. Yeah, yeah. I mean, remember when Overpass came out, everyone was like.
Yeah, exactly. You know, we've seen with like Cash, for example, at this tournament. You know, how the meta just actually does change, you know, like.
I'm completely inverted with that.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Like, If the average amount of rounds you're getting on a map like Cash, which is traditionally CT-sided, is now up to 10, then, you know.
We have to do a lot here. Got a lot of time still. Yeah, he has got an orb.
Come on, let's be real. McAlealy's not there.
That is the problem, isn't it? And obviously, there's another way you can get up on there. That's actually one of the main things about the map now. There's so many ways you can get up to the top level. Whereas the whole thing about Nuke was, if you had that advantage of being up there, it's a lot more difficult to do.
I thought he was going to go for the base 360 no-scope.
They're going to have a bunch of map points, aren't they? Oh, that's the next one.
Yeah, the next one will take the match point, so... North America actually might do this now.
Simple on 34
kills. The money's low. We've got a couple of Tech Nines coming in. Has Nico got a rifle? Yeah, Nico's got a rifle, so yeah. There's still hope.
Kenny Michael Lely with the Tech Nines.
And Geraint's had one of those like sleeper games that he tends to have.
Yeah,
right?
just
gets lots of kills. Like,
36 kills, no bother.
Unspectacular, but
yes. Just picking them up.
Yeah. So let's see where they're going to go this time. Are they just going to do something fast? So I think that's what's been missing from the game, really.
Well, I think the trouble is, of course, it needs a little bit of chemistry and strategy to make these T-side work, and it's difficult if you haven't got
it. You can see as well, this is interesting, because obviously in Counter-Strike Source in 1.6, you didn't have Molotovs, right? Like, to sort of think about. They've reworked this radio room, and it still looks like you can shut it down pretty easy with just one Molotov.
But it's still really
one
tough.
One Molotov or one smoke. You know?
Really, really tough. One of the other challenges, of course, down low, we've seen it with that little room gone on the left-hand side, which everyone used to hide in.
Yeah.
And a way of getting back out of there on the right-hand side, as you look at the bomb site low, you can actually get back around behind the vents now as well, which is really good. It's not a dead end.
So I'm interested to see how this all
I think part of the problem as well is that not in a real game, if the first person dies when he goes in on Terrorist side, someone rushes in.
Yeah, you want to take an advantage.
But the moment they're just like, oh, wait back, still got
time.
Well,
this is actually smart play what they're doing here. You know, where you just control... Oof, nearly got the headshot there. Where you sort of just hold the map, you just control the areas, and you wait for the CT rotations. So you take what's a 5v4 advantage, turn it into a 5v3 advantage. That's what you want to be doing, really, on the map, just in general. There's no need to overcommit if you've got time on the clock. So.
Still looking for this final round. Which way is it going to go?
I haven't seen much from Skadoodle this game. There we go.
Here we are.
Going to see it now. He's got one.
1v1.
Skadoodle versus Get Ryan. Skadoodle will crush the round. So all three go to the America team. They need one more.
Yep. America, going to put you all out of your misery. Why do we have Ric Flair chants? Never understood it. A Counter-Strike with him.
So it's pretty much three,
it's simple,
three match
doing
points.
It. Look how tilted he is, and you're winning.
That's what happens, though.
It's unreal.
He's a perfectionist.
I mean, in some way, Paul reminds me of Ric Flair, actually. Obviously, the nature boy, he's got that flair about him. Known for his calls, refuses to retire.
Wow.
But a legend of the game.
A legend.
We brought him back again.
Too sweet.
So this could be the one. So, America here, they're sort of spread out around the map. They're looking for some early picks, get some early map control. You can see the CTs are in some, elevated positions. Don't think that smoke's actually going to do too much there. I think just going to take the hook window up. KS does get that first pick. So Europe fighting. And then Charles going to come into the hut and even end up by taking out Get Right. So, nice. No, Nico with another knife, just a stealth knife. We just missed that one.
Yep.
And it's on Simple. Don't get triggered there, Simple. Flashbacks, of course.
They have been the most enjoyable.
That's what I mean. I think Nico and Simple have sort of entered into the spirit of what an All-Star game is about, and they are trying to style on each other and get some bragging rights. Everyone else is kind of doing it, and that's a good trade there. Shroud was actually low HP, able to get the kill on Nico, so this is good.
I mean, it's one thing when Get Right and Nico are like going around, so that is their style of play, but people like Kenny S, I think to some degree, like Tarik a bit, these are supposed to be flashy players, they're supposed to be diving out there, going for the game. I think they've been playing a little bit too passively, just trying to win the game actually in a bad way, as opposed to you go for the flashy plays in the All-Star game, you want to have the clip that everyone remembers.
Yep, so Hiko's actually managed to get up into heaven here, and he's coming around and he's going to get off the Makalele. Oh. He's going to get that first kill, of course. He is Makalele.
2v2 for the game,
A crash test dummy. Rain with the spray. Hiko with a trade. Oh. But an aid from downtown is going to take out Kenny S, so we've got at least one more round to go here. So we'll see if he's able to shut out. Another overtime here, which would be mad alive.
So literally, I think Duncan's actually twitching right now.
No, what?
He needs Twitter.
Stamina look.
Sport to him.
Yep, I was going to say, Skudel's going to take an AK here. So this is actually an important round because I'm joking about the overtime. The overtime's likely if America don't win this because of the way the economy's going. So they haven't even invested into an AWP here, and that could be problematic. So it looks like they are going to do a fast rush. But there you go, there's those Molotovs again, shooting down the hut, but they managed to get out through the squeaky door. Rain having a peek here. Tarik's going to get that first pick. You can see that Get Right's up in heaven. He's going to throw a Molotov down onto the site.
Kenny has in the smoke.
Yeah.
Get Right Biden this time.
And he's missed it, he's whipped it. So America in a good position.
This is ideal. We're going to get a black bomb down. All these weapons. Get Right comes in now.
Get Right's got the bomb.
Three to find.
Yep. So.
Just three players. Simple's going to come in. Is he going to get a second here?
He's going to get two.
Oh, he tried to get two. He does get the second.
He's done it.
Two knives for Simple.
You get
and
the
Makalele now
all,
is the last man alive that can stop America winning the All-Star game.
It's
not going to happen. And the winners of the All-Stars, Team America!
See, that's the spirit of the All-Stars.
Yeah, exactly. That's what you're supposed to be doing. I'll tell you what, right?
Styled on him.
This entire event, Simple has got to be like one of the standout players here. There's the USA champ.
Right. MVP for me. Just purely on style application, not just in the All-Star game, but all the way through. He's done it even in the other games.
And this is the thing, you talk about like how he's sort of embraced the American culture and ingratiating himself over the crowd. That was like unthinkable for Simple doing that like a few years ago.
Also, I thought a great moment was, even though he is this young guy and he's not always as socially aware, he knew exactly the moment within that game when he did the he hyped the crowd, he kind of read the room and that stuff. And obviously that's another thing, we'd never seen him on the really, really big stage. You don't know, sometimes those guys who are cocky, they shut down a bit, but no, he was loving it, he was in his element, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, even the point where he got up and high five. He got, I mean, I think probably admin had to warn him or something, because I don't think you're allowed to do that normally. But it just shows that kind of passion and the vibrance of these guys. Great. I really look forward to see where his career goes.
Yeah, and obviously on the European side of things, yeah, get right to the old master. But, you know, Nico's showing he belongs in this type of company. And I do wonder what's going to happen after this major for him, because obviously you've got Mouse Sports underachieving again, not getting that legendary status. And he's going to be one of the most sort of highly sought players right now. Every time someone's got a vacancy to fill, everyone's saying you've got to get Nico in there. Now, obviously, Mouse Sports have got to keep him and build a team around him. But I think they've got to make changes, or Nico's got to get smart and get himself into another
team. Good to see Slasher into the event after all there, Rich.
Yeah.
He's looking in the background with his camera.
Yeah, looking
getting good. Back to the old school roots of journalism. Yeah, so, love you.
But yeah, so I mean, you know, you want to talk about All-Star games. Obviously, some people rose to the occasion, other people are just sort of treating it like a boogie game. But Simple and Nico, for me, have really stood out here today. They are star players. They live up to the name.
Well, thank you very much, gents. We do have an interview with Mr. Simple himself, who's with Chris on the stage.
Thank you, Red Eye. Simple, let's teach these Brits how to get this crowd rolling. USA!
USA! USA! USA! USA! USA!
That's what I'm talking about, baby. Now, first and foremost, I have to ask you, what do you think of the new Nuke?
Great, man.
And talk to me a little bit about your competition. Who was the toughest guy on the other side for the European team?
Christopher Allison and Nico. Yep.
Get right, causing some problems early. Nico towards the end there, and of course, you finally closed it out for us. I gotta hand you, this is the trophy, the MVP trophy. Give it up for Simple, ladies and gentlemen. And before I let you go, I gotta get your prediction. You played against Luminosity last night. You've been watching Na'Vi all week. Who do you think is gonna be walking home with the big one? Who is gonna be crowned our champions here today?
If Luminosity gonna play like yesterday, I think Na'Vi gonna win. I just want to say that it's not a 100% game was for Luminosity. They should have a lot of confidence right now. They're playing another final against Na'Vi. I wish good luck for both teams.
Good guys, Simple guys, and we are going to have a great match for all of you when we return. It's Brazil versus the CIS. Luminosity takes on Na'Vi when we return.